I went through hell. It was horrendous.
So much, not just physical suffering, but also like spiritual suffering during this crisis.
To be 18 and have your mum pass away, to then be shoved into complete isolation is honestly awful.
Obviously with the coronavirus, we've had to close our regular service. Our young people with their sort of underlying health issues are a wee bit at higher risk.
Bye. Whoa.
Part of our response has been a soup kitchen, which we've been established. So we've cooked in the last 2 days 180 meals of soup.
When you go out to the church today, there's nobody there, and you're looking at a red dot.
It was going at 100 miles an hour to 0 miles per hour, and I suppose I needed something to wind me down.
We've been delivering food parcels this morning to people in vulnerable areas. I'm on my last delivery.
They can't go outside the front gate. Some can't go outside the house. We just came up with a suggestion that let's take the exercise to the streets for people.
He wants us to come in, doesn't think we should all be outside. But he's healthy and he's reached 100.
There is no doubt that there will be companies that will not survive this period of time.
Putting on our aprons and gloves outside the patient's door.
So as you can see, there's a wee strip here, so this can be moulded to the shape of your face.
I suppose we live in a very rural area, slap bang in the middle of the Spearn Mountains. Done the usual rounds, run around the house, getting everybody else off the internet. We've 5 people in the house, and everybody obviously wants to be on, especially with everyone at home now.
There definitely is more young carers out there that just aren't recognised by the system.
There were patients who lost their lives. A lot of the time, the hardest part about being a doctor is to accept this patient is just at the end of their life.
The hardest bit for me was probably leaving my baby because he was tiny and like it just felt like a lot of life happened at once.
As all the coronavirus madness was kind of beginning, to be 18 and have your mum pass away, it was announced that lockdown had begun and we realised we couldn't have anything at all.
They took me by ambulance across to the city. I was on the COVID ward there. When you chat to people, you're the only person I know that ended up in ICU. Believe me, you do not want it.
With the arrival of pandemic and lockdown, most of the country suddenly experienced what life was like to have a disability, having to think about the little things we took for granted.
I do feel quite emotional about it. It's something that gives me great pleasure to have been part of.